यशोदानन्दन व्रज जन रञ्जन यशोद व्रज जन रञ्जन यशोदानन्दन व्रज जन रञ्जन यशोदानन्दन नरञ्जन यमुना तीरन चारि यमुना तीरा यमुना तीरावन चारि हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्णा Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Hare Jaya Prabhupadaya, 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 Jaya Prabhupadaya, Jaya Prabhupadaya. जय श्री हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय जगत कृष्ण प्रभुपाद की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय निताई गौर प्रेमानंदे ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय हरे कृष्णा वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम फिफ्थ कैंटो ऑफ श्रीमद्भागवतम चैप्टर 19 चैप्टर एंटाइटल्ड द आइसलैंड ऑफ जम्मूद्वीप Text 9 So please repeat after me Bharate ape varshe Bhagwan nar narayanakhya akalpantam उपचित धर्म ज्ञान वैराग्य ईश्वर्योपसमो परमात्मोपलब्धं अनुग्रहायात्म अनुकंपाया तपो अव्यक्त गति शरति भारते अपि वर्षे भगवान नारायणाख्य अकल्पांतम् उचिता धर्मज्ञान वैराग्ये ऐश्वर्योपशमो परमा आत्मोपलम्भनम् अनुग्रहाय आत्मतामनुकम्पाय तपो अव्यक्त गति शरति भारते अपि वर्षे भगवान नर नारायणाख्य अकल्पांतम उचित उपचित धर्म ज्ञान वैराग्ये ऐश्वर्योपशमो परमा आत्मोपलम्भम् अनुग्रहाय आत्मवताम् अनुकम्पाय तपो अव्यक्त गति शरति वर्ड बाय वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन मीनिंग एंड पर्पोर्ट वशिला प्रभुपाद भारते इन द भारत अपि ऑल्सो वर्षे द ट्रैक ऑफ लैंड भगवान द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड नारायण नर नारायणाख्य नोन एज नर नारायण अकल्प अंतम अप टू द एंड ऑफ द मिलेनियम उपचित इंक्रीजिंग धर्म रिलीजन ज्ञान नॉलेज वैराग्य रिनन्सिएशन और नॉन अटैचमेंट ऐश्वर्य मिस्टिक ऑपुलेंस उपसमा कंट्रोल ऑफ सेंसेस उपरमा फ्रीडम फ्रॉम फॉल्स ईगो आत्म उपलम्भनम सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन अनुग्रहाय टू शो फेवर आत्मवताम ऑन टू पर्सन्स इंटरेस्टेड इन सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन अनुकंपाय बाय कॉजलेस मर्सी तप ऑस्टेरिटीज अव्यक्त गति हूज ग्लोरीज आर इनकंसीवेबल चरते एग्जीक्यूट्स ट्रांसलेशन Shukdev Goswami continued, The glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are inconceivable. He has appeared in the form of Narayana in the land of Bharatvarsh at the place known as Badrikashram to favor his devotees by teaching them religion, knowledge, renunciation, spiritual power, sense control, and freedom from false ego. He is advanced in the opulence of spiritual assets and he engages in executing austerity until the end of this millennium. This is the process of self-realization. Please repeat after me. Shukdev Goswami continued, The glories of Supreme Personality of Godhead are inconceivable. He has appeared in the form of Narayan in the land of Bharatvarsha at the place known as Badrikashram to favor his devotees by teaching them religion, knowledge, renunciation, spiritual power, sense control, and freedom from false ego. He is advanced in the opulence of spiritual assets and he engages in executing austerity until the end of this millennium. This is the process of self-realization. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. People in India may visit the temple of Narayan at Badrik Ashram just to learn how the Supreme Personality of Godhead in His incarnation as Narayan engages in austerities to teach the people of the world how to achieve self-realization. It is impossible to realize oneself simply by absorbing oneself in speculation and material activities. One must be very serious about self-realization and the practice of austerity. Unfortunately, the people of this age of Kali do not even know the meaning of austerity. Under these circumstances, the Lord has appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to bestow upon the fallen souls the easiest method of self-realization, technically called Cheto Darpan Marjanam. Cleansing of the dirt from the core of one's heart. This method is extremely simple. Anyone can chant the glorious Krishna Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. In this age, there are different forms of so-called advanced scientific knowledge, such as anthropology, Marxism, Freudianism, nationalism, and industrialism. But if we work very hard under their guidance, instead of adopting the process practiced by Narayan, we shall waste our valuable human form of life. Thus, we shall certainly be cheated and misled. ॐ ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं विस्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरौ श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादां सहगणरघुनाथता श्रीविशाखान्वितं स नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामीनिति नामिने। नमस्ते शारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरूभश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा। सो आई एम फीलिंग वेरी अनक्वालिफाइड सिटिंग हेयर and is speaking from Srimad Bhagavatam. So I seek blessings of all the assembled Vaishnavas, all the senior devotees, to bless me so that I can speak something from Srimad Bhagavatam, something relevant. Jai Shri Shri Radha Madan Mohan Krishna Balaram Shri Gaur Nitai Ki Jai Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. So this is the new section which is going to be discussed here about the pastime of Nar Narayan. Before that, pastime of Lord Ramchand were little discussed. So at Kim Purush Varsha, Hanumanji is worshipping Lord Ramchandra, and now the description about the Bharat Varsha, where Lord Nar Narayan Rishi is being worshipped by Narad Muni. So I was reading through about the Nar Narayan Rishi. So it has been described in the Shastras that how the son of Brahma Dharma, who performed a great austerity to have Lord as their son. So Nar Narayan was born as their son from the womb of Mother Murti. So in this verse about Lord Nar Narayan has been described that how the Lord Nar Narayan appeared in Badrika Ashram to favor his devotees by teaching them religion, knowledge, renunciation, spiritual power, self-control and freedom from false ego. So there is one wonderful pastime in the Srimad Bhagavatam only in the 11th canto, where this the wonderful activities of the Nar Narayan has been described. So I was going through that how the Nar Narayan Rishi, they were performing austerity, and they were performing huge austerity, and by seeing them the Indra got bewildered. And they thought that they are now, after performing austerity, they are going to claim my post. Because like by performing 100 Ashwamedh Yagya, by performing 100 Ashwamedh, the one can claim the post of Indra by performing 100 Ashwamedh Yagya. So anyone who performs austerity, it becomes a little anxiety, it brings anxiety to Indra. So he tried to disturb the austerity of Nar Narayan Rishi. So he sent this Cupid to disturb him. So as soon as the Cupid reached with all their paraphernalia of their associates to disturb Nar Narayan Rishi, so by They tried to disturb, but Narayana Rishi was not disturbed by their action. So, I will read little from Srimad Bhagavatam. King Indra became fearful, thinking of Narayana Rishi would become very powerful by his severe penances and seize Indra's heavenly kingdom. Thus, Indra, not knowing the transcendental glories of the incarnation of Lord, sent Cupid and his associates of the Lord's residence in Badrikashram. As the charming breezes of spring created a most sensuous atmosphere, Cupid himself attacked the Lord with arrow in the form of irresistible glances of the beautiful woman. So this Cupid actually, he went there and he tried to disturb the Narayana. It has been described that how the Cupid has five arrows to disturb different senses. So he shoots five types of arrow, like the arrow for taste, smell, touch, sound and sight. So as soon as somebody is suited by these five arrows, his mind gets agitated to enjoy all these. This has been described as tanmatras, to enjoy all these things. So those who are being attacked by the Cupid, there has been so many stories in the Shastras which says that how by falling prey to Cupid attack, the living entities has fallen into ditch of the sufferings. So one pastime was of the heavenly damsel Pushpavati and Malyavan, that this Pushpavati was actually the Apsara. So she was at Indra's court and she used to dance in front of Indra to give him pleasure. So once she was attracted by Malyavan, one of the member, and so they both were they got married, and both were in once upon a time they were dancing in the court of Indra. So they were dancing for the pleasure of Indra, but they were not much aware about the Indra, but they were trying to enjoy each other. So seeing this, their steps were not quite matching. Their senses were disturbed by each other. So their actions were not quite befitting. So this Indra cursed them to fall into the form of pisachas. So but we can see on the other side how the lords and lord devotees, they are never disturbed by the action of the Cupid. Like we have example of this Haridas Thakur, who was this Lakshira. She tried to disturb Haridas Thakur, but he was not agitated. Similarly, the Lord is also manifesting this quality, that how the Lord is not being agitated by it. And we all are very fortunate to be at the lotus feet of Shri Radha Madan Mohan. Madan Mohan, who attracts the Cupid. So after this incident, the Cupid tried to agitate the mind of the Narayana Rishi, but they couldn't able to do that. So they were thinking that Premier Lord, understanding the offense committed by Indra, did not become proud. Instead, he spoke laughingly as follows to the Cupid and his followers, who were trembling before him. So they tried to disturb, Narayana and Rishi were not disturbed, and seeing that they were fearful, he may not be a common person, he may be something powerful. So they got disturbed. These demigods who came to disturb the meditation of Narayana. So Lord, to console them, that don't worry, do not fear. O mighty Madan, O wind god and the wives of demigod, rather please accept these gifts I am offering you and kindly sanctify my ashram by your presence. So this is the magnanimity of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that how He is not taking any type of offense of the Cupid, but he is giving them consolation that do not worry about that. and they were fearful and Lord was making them comfortable. Similar incidents comes also when this Bhrigu Muni, while testing the who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he kicked at the chest of Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu at that time just caught hold of Bhrigu Muni and told that you are by my heart chest, your lotus feet had maybe it may got pain. So this is the Lord's magnanimity. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur also says like that, how the devotees has to practice this tolerance. Vriksh sham chama gun karobi sadhan prati himsha tyagi anne karohi palan. That one should try to develop the tolerance like the trees, and not to get if somebody tries to offend, if somebody tries to disturb you, then even then you should not got disturbed. But prati himsha, we should not take we should not develop a revengeful attitude toward him if somebody commits some offense toward us. But we should try to prati himsha tyagi anne karuvi palan, we should try to take care of them. So Lord was consoling them, do not worry. And in this way that Lord is showing his quality of upparam, the freedom from the false ego. We are discussing actually these six quality which has been described in the verse. So this is the another quality Lord showed, that freedom from the false ego. Then when these demigods, Lord, actually this Narayana Rishi with all the paraphernalia, he worshipped these demigods because they came to the ashram of Narayana Rishi, so he offered his worship. And then to show his opulence, were this Narayana Rishi, this they just put one flower onto his thigh, and from that lot of damsels came, apsaras came in front of the demigods. So they were all bewildered by seeing them, because they were incomparable in beauty. They came to disturb Narayan Rishi, but on the other side, Lord Narayan, they produced Urvashi and other apsaras from their thigh. So by seeing them, they were attracted, and Lord Narayan told, "You can choose any one of them," and they ultimately chose Urvashi, and they took her with them. And seeing this, they were feeling very ashamed that we came to disturb Narayan Rishi, and Narayan Rishi, they are offering him something. So in this way, Lord shows his opulence, aishwarya, and at last is the renunciation. So the Supreme Lord of the Lord then smiled slightly and told the representative of heaven who are bowing down before him, "Please choose one of them, woman. Whoever you find suitable for you, she will become the ornament of the heavenly planet." And in this way, he gave Urvashi to them. So he didn't get attached to anything. He gave to them for take to the heaven. So yesterday I was seeing that about Badrika Ashram. I had never been at, but I was seeing that how the Badrika Ashram is still the Lord is performing austerity in the form of two mountains, Nar and Narayan mountain. Still the Lord is there, and Prabhupada writes in purport about that. The personality of God in his incarnation as Nar Narayan engages in austerities to teach the people of world how to achieve self-realization. So this austerity, it help us to control the senses, but on the other side it also sometimes becomes the cause of our pride. It increases our false ego also. So but it is necessary to take up austerities to progress on the path of self-realization, but what type of austerities we can have, so that, or in what mood we should take up the austerity so that it should not increase our false pride. So that has been wonderfully narrated by the pastime of this Lord Brahma, who is taking up the responsibility on the behalf of Supreme Personality of Lord, but he is praying on the other side, he is taking up austerities for creation, and on the other side he is in a prayerful mood that I should not develop the false pride, I should not develop false ego. And in this way, and kindly protect me from the path of deviation. For starting a project or for taking up new big responsibility, we have to do hardships also. So sometimes it may be the cause of our pride also. But how we can protect from this attitude? By taking shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by praying to them for their mercy. So, because performing austerity is the, it helps, like for the devotee, what type of austerity they can take? They can, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, that how the one should observe the Ekadashi with full endeavor. Madhav Tithi Bhakti Janni Jatne Palan Kari. That in this way we can take up hardship for observing Ekadashi very nicely. And on the other, what type of austerities we can take? Like it's most difficult to act against the will of the mind. This is also one type of austerity, that going against the will of the mind and following the instruction of the superiors or for the pleasure of the lordship, that is cooperating with each other. So in this way we can move on the path of self-realization. This control of senses is required to engage and absorb our consciousness in Krishna, because this sense enjoyment and devotional service, they go ill together. Means we can't have both, enjoying our senses, on the other side performing devotional services. How? Because when we have tendency to enjoy our senses, to get satisfaction to our senses, what will happen? Our consciousness or our mind will be absorbed in finding the ways to enjoy, to gratify the senses. And in that way, we will not able to perform devotional service in proper mood. So therefore, it has been told that if we want to perform devotional service, we should rest from the platform of sense enjoyment. And Lord also does not accept even a tinge of pride in his devotees. And as soon as he is seeing that the devotees are developing some type of false pride due to their actions, immediately Krishna comes to correct them. Because Krishna, for the devotees, Krishna slaps the devotee for his wrong deeds. But now Krishna never kicked the devotee, that you are not qualified and you just get lost. No, but Krishna slaps. Slaps means he just comes and gives some hit and try to correct us. Just like yesterday I was hearing one lecture where Sarvam Prabhu was describing the pastime of how Krishna, this Satyabhama was there in Dwarka. Satyabhama was there. So she developed the pride that I am so beautiful. And this Garuda was there. And Garuda was thinking that I am the carrier of the Lord. I am the fastest vehicle on which the Lord travels. And this Sudarshan was also there. And he was thinking that I am the protector. I give protection to the devotees. So this then once Lord in the Dwarka, he told Garuda to go to Kim Purushvarsha and call Hanuman. So this Garuda went to Kim Purushvarsha, and then he saw Hanuman as usual worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Ramchandra, in full absorption. And he told that Krishna has called you. Krishna is calling you. Krishna wants to see you. So he told, I am worshipping and you go, I am just coming behind you. So he told, no, You just come with me. I came to take you. You just sit on my back and I will take you to Dwarka. So this, so Hanuman thought that what he is talking about. And the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is the seat of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. How I can sit on it? So he told that, he tried to persuade, he was not ready to hear. He just caught hold of the wings of the Garuda and just thrown into the water. So this Garuda was just, so Lord after perform, this Hanuman just performing his worship and he went to see Lord Krishna at Dwarka. And the day this Krishna called Hanuman, so Lord says that, oh Chakra, you just give protection to the Dwarka so that nobody can enter Dwarka. So this Sudarshan Chakra was just rotating over Dwarka and trying to protect Dwarka. So just Hanuman came and saw this Chakra not allowing to enter. He asked Chakra, but the Chakra stopped him that you are not allowed to enter. Lord has told nobody is allowed today. So then Hanuman told, Lord is calling me and why you are stopping me? And then he just caught hold of this Chakra and just put into his between the teeth and just went inside. And when he went inside, this Satyabhama and Krishna was sitting together. And just by seeing Satyabhama, the Hanuman was agitated. Oh Lord, who is she? I was expecting Sita Devi with you. Who is this lady? So in this way, in one shot, this Lord Krishna broke the pride of everyone. Like Garuda was thinking, I am the fastest, but Hanuman rejected him. And then Chakra was thinking, I am the protector. Then he just caught hold. Actually, and then this Satyabhama was thinking, I am so beautiful. And in this way, Lord destroyed the pride of devotees. So, and there are so many other instances also where we can find that how Supreme Personality of God and helping His devotee to come out of small hurdles in the spiritual life. Like we can have the example of Indra also. So many times he is committing mistake, but he surrendered to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Lord is giving him all protection, slapping him again and again. And Indra is ready to accept the slaps, changes, whatever Lord want to do. When this pastime happened, this Govardhan Lila happened, so this Indra was very much ashamed to go in front of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, because he is the king of the heaven and there are other people also. So Lord was also understanding the mood of Indra, so he went the other side of the Govardhan, where this is Govind Kund is there. So when Lord was thinking that Indra will come to meet me, so he was just in a mood. He was just traveling around and he was seeing the how much damage it has caused. Then when Lord was in seclusion, this Indra came and asked forgiveness. So Lord is also knowing that if I will give him correction in front of everyone, then it may be insult for him. Let him speak in alone only. So in this way, Lord is helping us to go through our spiritual life, because we can see how the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the ultimate doer of everything. But due to our deep-rooted tendency, egoistic tendency to enjoy separate from Krishna, makes us to feel the doer of activity. Jai Shri Radha Madan Mohan Krishna Balam Gaur Nitai Ki Jai Shri Shri Narasingh Dev Bhagwan Ki Jai Jagannath Baldeshwar Maharani Ki Jai. So due to false ego, sometimes we think that we are the doer and it is our tendency to forget Krishna. But though we are surrendered to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we have taken this path, or whatever type of devotion we are having or whatever we are offering to Krishna, Krishna is ready to accept it full-hearted and ready to help the devotee who are trying to take shelter of Him. Because it's a deep desire of Krishna that all the living entities should come back to home, back to Godhead. In Srimad Bhagavatam, this has been told that the cause of appearance of the Lord is, this is the only purpose of appearance of Supreme Personality of Godhead, to reclaim the living entity back to home, back to Godhead. And we can also see from the pastime of Gop Kumar, when Lord saw Gop Kumar, he was so much, he was feeling so much joy just by seeing Gop Kumar, and they were hugging each other. So we can read further from the purport. It is impossible to realize himself, oneself, simply by absorbing oneself in speculation and material activities. So there are different types of the transcendentalists who try to understand the absolute truth and try to take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Like there are Karmi and Jnani, those who are by dint of their knowledge or by dint of their action, they are trying to take take shelter of the Lord. But apart from the devotional service, there is no other way to attain the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And in one of the purport, Srila Prabhupada is so much criticizing these tendency of jnana and karma that he is writing, any activity other than the transcendental loving service to the Lord is more or less a rebellious action against the Supreme Will. That any action other than the devotional service, why devotional service? Is because devotional service is a symptom of the surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And if somebody is not taking this path and trying his own way, that means he, a little or tinge of egoistic tendency toward the Lord is still there within his heart. So he may be, from the external point of view, he may be looking a transcendentalist, but he is cultivating jealousy toward the Lord. So apart from the devotional service, there is no other way. All the fruity activities, empirical philosophy and mysticism are more or less against the sense of subordination to the Lord. And any living entity engaged in such rebellious activity is more or less condemned by the laws of the material nature, which works under the subordination of the Lord. So in this way we can understand that how the devotional service are the only ways, any other way they are the rebellious action of the Lord only. And in the last section of the purport, Prabhupada is writing that how the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared and he made the process so easy. Just by the self-realization has been become so easy, just Cheto Darpan Marjanam, cleansing the dirt from the core of one's heart. This method is extremely simple. Anyone can chant glorious Krishna Sankirtan, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So just by chanting the holy name of the Lord, by engaging ourselves in the devotional services, we can get perfection. Because these other paths are actually very difficult also. But by the mercy of the Srila Prabhupada, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that by engaging our tendency in the service of Krishna, they get purified. Whatever tendency, whatever inclination, or whatever skills we are having, we can engage in service of Krishna and we can get purified. And this process of chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is so powerful that just by coming in touch with the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we feel that we are getting purified. That those new students who comes in touch of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, they also within a few months only, they could able to recognize how they are, by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, dirt within their heart is getting washed off. And Bhagavad describes how that Krishna residing within the heart, entering through the ears, residing within the heart, cleanses one's anarthas and accept him as at his shelter. So we should take up, we already have taken this process, now we should try to practice it with enthusiasm, and by the mercy of the devotees, we are able to succeed in our path of Krishna consciousness. There are various other ways, but they are just a waste. They are just a waste to the human form of life. So I will stop it here. Does anybody has any question, any suggestion, any comment related? बस आकाश प्रभु। So Akash Prabhu is asking a very nice question that there are great acharyas, how they are extending their services, how they are extending themselves. Like the example of the Goswamis, he is telling that how they took austerities, they performed austerity. Austerity means they extended themselves for the pleasure of the Lord. Srila Prabhupada extended. So what is our checkpoint? Whether we are in the imitation zone or we are on the right path. I know. So actually we can check like whenever we are performing, we are some like I can give my example whenever I do Nirjala Ekadashi, so sometimes little pride comes. So many devotees are taking prasad, I am fasting from the ayan, I am not taking water. So this could be checkpoint whether by performing austerity it's increasing our pride or it helping us to become more humble. Actually it will happen only when we are engaged in the devotional service, chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra more and more. Like if we are not engaging in devotional service or not in a prayerful mode, obviously it will increase our anarthas or it will increase our pride only. But if we are engaged nicely in the devotional services or in a proper mode we are serving, then obviously with the time we can cultivate the right mode. We can ourselves check whether it is increasing our false pride or it is helping me to become more humble. This is what my understanding, others can add up. थैंक यू निमेशंत प्रभु। जगत गुरु श्री प्रपात की जय, अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय, ताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि।